Hi, what's up, family? It is your boy Ramose from here, Ramose TV, back into another vlog. So today I wanna discuss with you how I won the Turkiye burslari scholarship. But actually, isn't that the case? But I wanna discuss with you why I didn't. Instead of discussing with you why I won, why I didn't. So the don'ts, so that you don't miss any scholarship opportunities. For those who are applying for Turkiye burslari, those who are applying for ISTB Turkiye scholarship program, or for those who are trying now to apply for, maybe we're gonna be applying for Islamic Development Bank scholarship program. Alright, back into our video. So I remember when I was doing the application, like back in the days, 2015, yeah, I didn't have much clue about following up the procedures or following up the steps, following up their criteria so that to get selected, to increase chances to get selected. And I wasn't aware, and I had nobody to guide me, nobody around me telling me like what you should do, like this you should research and try to spend much of time because it is your future attached to. I had nobody. By that time I had my friends who were abroad, but they weren't there due to under scholarship, etc. So I was lacking some details. And I remember when I was doing the application back in 2015, that was my first time for me applying for Turkiye burslari scholarship. Yeah, so when I went for the application, that time I just finished your level, so I just say let me apply for the scholarship. I wanna go abroad. Yeah, but actually you need to apply when you are having a high school. So I was at high school and was in the middle of the studies, whereby the application opened, because we differ a little bit on the application, no, on the study calendar, whereby here maybe they start as we start, like 4 months is difference for the schools and the universities between Turkey and my country, Tanzania, by the way. I'm talking about that, you know, already. So I did the application, but I remember when I was filling the application, like on the major challenging part, other sections or other checklists, such as personal information, is normal, general, like in every single scholarship, it's just general. Personal information, you fill about the family, income, if it's about the number of siblings, those are normal. You come maybe to contact information, which are basic stuffs. In every single application, these are the basic stuffs you will have to deal with. But there is a part like maybe address, which are the basic, depending on whatever country, and every single scholarship you meet with that. But for the scholarship, the major challenging was on the academic background or education background. So on education background, since they had middle school and they got high school, then you go bachelor's, master's, and bachelor's and postgraduate or associate degrees also have been added on those sections. So that was the most challenging part. But if come to the party for hobbies, it was easier, just normal to feel about hobbies, to feel about extracurricular activities. And even I saw some of my comments, someone was saying, what if I don't have extracurricular activities? What if I don't have the hobbies? How comes you don't have the hobbies? Just say you don't know what are examples of hobbies, or what are list of hobbies which you can choose the one that fits in you. You don't know that, but you can say I don't have any hobby, I don't have any extracurricular activities. You might have, but you are not aware of it. Yeah, so for all those, the remaining categories were normal feeling, even if someone from middle school also can understand, feel about your address, feel about mobile number, feel about your billing address, feel about maybe the referee, someone who's referring you, feel about, those are the basics. So everybody can feel, just normal and understandable. But the part was on education. So for my mistake, what I did is, on the middle school, I had to put my secondary school, which actually is a middle school, like in different countries, like for those who are doing in different countries, you call that as a middle school. Yeah, so I had to put that. And on the part for the high school, since I was in high school already, but I didn't know. So I had just to put the middle school over there. So double middle school certificate I had to put over there, the one which I used to graduate from the O-level studies or middle school. For other countries, you call it middle school. So I had to put that. I had to put the middle school, the education went. But that was the mistake number one, which made me not to win that scholarship. So the correct one was, if someone is on filling that part, it means you can fill the middle school. You put your middle school certificate, because you have graduated already from middle school or all level studies. And then on the high school is where you can put the transcript showing that you're still studying, you're still in your studies, like your final year of studies in your high school. But I didn't know that, and nobody had knowledge. All of my friends who were in my cycle, nobody knew that. Yeah, I was just trying to grab the education, watching some videos, but I had nobody to discuss with about what should I write, how should I fill it correctly. So that's what the first mistake that made me not to be selected or even being shortlisted for an interview or for the second round of evaluation. So I got a direct knockout. Majority of you guys might have direct knockout from the age limit or a direct knockout, I don't know from where, but that was my major knockout. But the other problem which I faced, you know, when you finish filling all these details and they'll go above, like you go for further, which is part two of application, on choosing, agreeing to the terms, going to referees, choosing the location for the interview, putting the letter of intent, as well as selecting university, the second part of the application. So within that part also, the other knockout was on the letter of intent. Like I had no time that time, you know. Our high school studies, you just started, it was a boarding school, so you need to stay at school. You're not allowed to have a phone, mobile phone. Yeah, we are not allowed, like as a student, being primary student, secondary or high school student, until you get into university, so but you are free to use a mobile device or a mobile device as a student. So that's how the system works in our country. Yeah, but it's fine, cool. They don't allow, because they prevent much destruction. You know, majority of us who are still teenagers for that age, you know, blah blah, we're not much aware, but not much attached into positive users for this technology. So that's why the system stay like that, kind of keeping us busy, focusing much on the studies for that time. But it's good. So for that time, I didn't have much time or didn't have the opportunity to explore more about the letter of intent too. So even how to write a perfect or a concrete letter of intent also was a major problem as well. So filling it, you just have few time to prepare. You just do it roughly, you prepare, oh, this might work, because I got good grades from middle school, good grades from all level studies, I'm gonna win it. So you do like that, and guess what? You got knocked out. So these were the major challenges that made me to miss this scholarship. So for you also who are trying to apply for different scholarship, might not be Turkiye Burslari, might not be other or any other scholarship, but I'm talking about Turkiye Burslari a little bit, because there's one of subscriber asking me how did you get the scholarship. So I decided to talk about why I didn't get the scholarship, because if I talk about how I got it, I might just base on my performance, ABC and other stuff. But if I talk about why I didn't, it might open up for you not to do this mistake, so that you increase the greater chance to win your chances. So my advice, final advice, killing the video over here, is when you are doing the application, make sure on the age limit, Yeah, I've seen age limit. Majority of people, you are knocked out on the age limit, so you can try to forge when creating an account, because they need maybe someone to be born 2000, maybe not earlier than. So meaning if you are born 1999, down over there on numbers 1998, etc., you can try to write the date of birth which is above 2000, and then after that, you can, when you are filling the detail, your date of birth might be seen on the certificate, but when you're filling, you'll be eligible by the system to continue with the application. The rest, you leave it with your prayers. But also, on educational filling, make sure you be very careful. For diplomas, applicant, when you are filling the part for the education, on the part for the middle school, you can put your middle school, which is high school, actually, all diplomas as well as diploma as well as high school graduates, all of us, we pass through middle school studies. So for those who goes into college after the middle school. So also you can use the part where they need high school, you can put your diploma certificate or your college certificate. But also your college certificate, you might put it at the associate degree, so that to make it aware that, okay, this guy didn't go with the high school advanced studies, went into college studies, and now qualifies to apply. So for those who did clinical medicine, which is a diploma actually in medicine, so you can use that to apply for medicine, putting that detail. So the education part is very, very important, because you are applying for education, so is one among the best criteria, one among the most important part which we need to look at you when we are investigating your application. We need to look at that. So the education part, don't mess with it. Other things on the parts which are mandatory, try to be very strict, like research. Take your time, watch some of the videos where people that have explained. You can watch another video more. If you get a time to talk with some people who got the exposure, talk to them, get that guidance, like about what to do, about what they think is right, but also be careful to whatever you're talking to. Yeah, also that's most important, because you can get also false information from someone who doesn't know, but doesn't wanna be real, that I don't know that, like I do not know, I'm not aware of that, but I wanna brag, okay, I know, let me ask, let me check, let me do what, etc. And on the letter of intent, spend much of your time, majority of you face a very one big challenge, you don't start writing, right? Roughly, then you can go with it slowly by revising, and you'll be correcting your mistakes, your grammatical mistakes, slowly. So that was all I wanted to discuss with you.